Welcome back to another episode of The Unfair Advantage, episode 4, and we are diving right into AI hardware. If you can notice, maybe I've got some of that on today, but I want to talk about some of the stuff that is grinding my gears, and I'm talking pissing me off because, ladies and gentlemen, this shit isn't ready across the board. Look, it's fun, it's cool, it's exciting, all of it looks great, but damn it. It's not working. We are in a state of let's build it and then let's build the hardware and then build the software in the back. It's a state of we are having these ideas and let's make people get excited and then figure it out. And I'm tired of it. This thing is a hot, steaming piece of garbage that does not work, does not do a damn thing. And I bought it because of marketing. Incredible design. I love the way that it looks. But when I put it on, I'd say last week, I couldn't even get it set up.
Welcome to the Unfair Advantage podcast, presented by AIMarketingTools.com and hosted by Justin Day. The Unfair Advantage podcast brings clarity to AI for small business owners and entrepreneurs. Using our no-nonsense approach helps you understand how to take AI and make it the MVP for your business.
Welcome back to another episode of The Unfair Advantage, episode 4, and we are diving right into AI hardware. If you can notice, maybe I've got some of that on today, but I want to talk about some of the stuff that is grinding my gears. And I'm talking pissing me off because, ladies and gentlemen, this shit isn't ready across the board. Look, it's fun, it's cool, it's exciting, all of it looks great, but damn it, it's not working. I've ordered just about every single hardware product out there, and I'm returning most of it. Not this, though. I'm keeping these. These are amazing and expensive, but I look awesome, and people stare at me at the airport. Yes, I do wear these on the airplane. You can catch me doing that left and right. I don't care. I have so many screens in my eyeballs. I will have 4 to 5 seizures a day. You know, that's okay though. First off, I just want to mention, we are in a state of let's build it and then let's build the hardware and then build the software in the back. It's a state of we are having these ideas and let's make people get excited and then figure it out. And I'm tired of it, okay? Let's first start off with these. These are technically run by AI, right? This is an Apple Vision Pro, and there is definitely AI built into it. You got Siri. I know that this year and the upcoming events with Apple, they're gonna highly dive into the AI experience in enhancing Siri. And I'm sure with the Vision Pro, that's going to come as well. You know, there's definitely some amazing apps within the Vision Pro where you can speak to it to create imagery and all that kind of stuff, which is amazing. I think this is definitely the future. This is the first iteration and this is a peek into the future. So I'm on board with this, while albeit as expensive and a lot of people are returning it, and maybe, you know, we don't know the ramifications of having your eyeballs glued to a kajillion pixel screen for long periods of time, but that's a later problem that will be a problem. So we'll get there in a few years, but let's circle back to the product of the century that is the biggest flop of all time. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the AI Humane Pin. This thing is a hot, steaming piece of garbage that does not work, does not do a damn thing. And I bought it because of marketing. Incredible design. I love the way that it looks. But when I put it on, I'd say last week, I couldn't even get it set up immediately, not because of the gestures or anything like that or like the setup. Immediately, it was too hot. I put it on and it was burning my skin. And this thing was just like, I could feel it on my skin and it was on fire. And it was just immediately like, I need to shut down because it's overheating. So that was an incredible day one experience. And then I gave it a break or whatever, and I was traveling with it, and I plugged it in, I charged it, whatever, I gave it some time, and then it just didn't turn on. I literally couldn't get it turned on, and it was like, okay, what is this for? And then I eventually got it turned back on, and I started playing around with it. I finally got it unlocked, and, you know, this is a $700 piece of hardware. that also requires its own mobile network for $23 or $30 a month. I think you get the first 3 months for free. Great. But guess what? It doesn't do anything. The latency with this, when you ask it a question, literally takes 30 seconds to a minute. It is insane. Like, it really doesn't do anything. The whole premise is for this is to do like screenless technology where you're getting insights instead of having to pull out your phone. While in theory, that's cool. If I'm having to wait 30 seconds to a minute, you know, and it doesn't really do anything, then what's the point? I mean, I would say that this is so primitive that maybe that they got all of the chips from AliExpress or anything. Like, that's the state that it's in, right? This is running off of a piece of cardboard that doesn't do anything. So I already return. I've got the return in motion. I was just waiting to get this on camera to show you guys. I've got it. Don't get it. Don't waste your money. I'm returning it. I'm going to talk about a couple other pieces of hardware as well. We've got the Meta AI glasses. I do like these. These are, I'd say, would be one of the best AI integrated hardware devices out there. So AI is actually integrated into this device that connects to your phone. And what it can do is take pictures and images, and they just release a beta update so that you can say, hey, Meta, look and tell me what I'm looking at. And it will take a picture, scan the picture, and tell you what you're looking at. So if it's a plant, or if you're at a restaurant and you want to say, hey, let me know what the reviews are, or even ask it questions in real time. Like, the latency there is fast. It's good. And the integration with it, it's got speakers in the head in this thing right here. So it's right in your ears, on your skulls. You could take phone calls, and the music and everything with it is actually really good. So I'd say this is probably the hardware leading the way. And another piece I want to talk about too is this one. It's the H1 dock. This is like a Charlie's Angel kind of deal where it looks cool. And, you know, you've got all the knobs, and like, you've got these, this is a speaker, you've got a feature to record all of your phone calls. This is a headset here. This is the volume. It can be a speaker for your computer, but the idea is to record all of your phone calls that come in outside of Zoom or whatever, so that it can take notes and then upload it to the cloud and give you transcriptions. The idea is cool. The practicality of it hasn't been working great. It sometimes works, sometimes doesn't. When we're also uploading things or even leveraging the speaker, I've had it sometimes just kind of go crazy. So that's not fun. But it's not as bad as, again, this steaming pile of garbage. And last product that I want to talk about here is the Rabbit R1. What they discovered, that this product is actually just running on an Android app. You can literally take the software from it and run it on your phone. When we review actually what the hardware does, the user experience isn't great. It's got a scroll wheel and a camera and these features that seem cool because, again, the hardware design is cool, just like this, the Humane thing. But it doesn't really, in practicality, do much. In fact, this morning it was supposed to ship to me today, but I canceled that. I don't want that. Like, it doesn't do anything. I got a bunch of reviews from, you know, MKHBD and all these other people that have reviewed it, and like, clearly there's we're in a state that this hardware isn't really doing anything. It's supposed to be multimodal, where it makes your life easier and or connects different apps so that you don't have to do as much clicking. It shortcuts and really gets to understand you, which the idea is great. And I think that that's where we're headed. But right now we are in such a state of go, 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 get it out there and we'll figure it out, that it's killing companies. And I mean, it's giving all of us creators great content, but man, the practicality of where we're at with most of them is just zero. So if you're thinking about buying some of these things, I'd highly wait. I think next year we're going to see a big increase in hardware, and that's going to continue to dial in as AI software dials in. That always then gets paired in with hardware. I think next year we'll start to see products that actually work and ongoing, but we are definitely in that state where this is early technology that's being adopted too fast for no reason in ideation. It's kind of like the tech bubble where, you know, Silicon Valley would buy ideas for apps that really didn't do anything. That's where we're at now with hardware. And now people are buying them and then returning them. And I think it's great for what they plan to do, but what it's doing now, They don't do shit. Now that we know that the hardware sucks across the board and we're just shipping items, creating items just to create them from ideation, we now have a clear understanding of what works, what doesn't, and maybe what the future can hold. And now that I've got my hands on some of these products and I've been using them over the last couple of months, I've got some ideas on where at least we should start and where it makes sense. Again, I think that these are one of the best products out there that are leading the way in how AI should be integrated, and that is a seamless experience, because this product with the glasses are something that you can use every day, and it's integrated seamlessly where you don't necessarily have to have an additional weird product like this Humane Pin or the Rabbit R1 that's an extension of your phone that's really just a phone and a smaller device. It's like, I think a starting point is creating that seamless experience and keeping it simple, right? You know, have the KISS method, keep it simple, stupid. And I think a lot of these companies try and overcomplicate it for the showmanship and just to get their company out there, and then they'll figure it out. So when we see hardware that's seamlessly integrated, that can make our lives better, easier, and faster, that's what's going to win. And then we can ideate and productize on top of that. Trying to do everything all at once right now like it's being done is just the wrong method. And clearly, it's just not working. I mean, take it for example again, like the Cybertruck. I'd say that's another piece of AI or hardware that's out there that's been a huge flop, right? It's another example of something that was rushed out there and now is getting recalled. In fact, I have an order out there that I need to cancel today, so remind me to do that later. But again, the future is exciting. We're in a great spot. I think if we can just slow down, make focus on simple and experience that's seamless, we are going to have just the most utopian future. But we'll see. I would say ultimately it's going to be leveraging AI on your phone to be multimodal so that you don't have to go between all of these apps. So it's talking to Siri or whatever that can do everything that you're needing just based off of a voice prompt. So I think the voice conversation to hardware is where it needs to go next. And then we need to ideate off of that for product hardware. But the idea is to have everything be multimodal so that, again, we can reduce the clicks or the, like, do I have this app? Do I not? And if we don't, then it automatically goes and finds it and does it for you. I think that's the next variation of, like, specifically with iPhones or just phones in general, it's getting there. But until that happens, like these other products, like it doesn't make sense. When it comes to the everyday practicality of leveraging AI hardware and just AI in general, it's going to be the phone. It's the thing that everybody has in their pocket, whether it be Android or Apple. That is the fastest way that we can integrate AI into our daily lives and benefit from it, as well as these companies gathering data to understand how we use it and why. So just think about walking down the street and instead of having to open Uber, then Uber Eats or, you know, calling your mom and all this stuff. It's like, let's just open up your iPhone or whatever, have a conversation with it, tell it exactly what you want and what's needed, and it'll go take all the apps, open everything for you, and it does the end result versus you having to think through all the things. If you don't have the app, then it's downloaded. If you don't have an account, then it's added. All this stuff can be automated with personalized AI, and then you add that in addition to mixed reality so that you can enhance the day-to-day life. So just imagine you're walking through the street in a new city and you have your phone out and you're just scanning through and you learn about all of the architecture or the history or just even like the Google reviews. Instead of having to go to Google reviews on your phone, if you're at a restaurant or if you're scrolling down, you know, a street and you want to see what the best restaurants are and all of the, you know, the reviews pop up and you can see recent reviews or like how many stars they have. That's the mixed reality experience leveraging AI and hardware that we should be striving for. And then we take that, iterate on top of it and bring the hardware to it instead of doing this backwards stuff that we're doing now. That's the future that I'd like to see. And that's where we're going. That's going to wrap it up for this weekly episode and albeit a rant, but I want to learn more about what you guys have had experiences with. If you've had AI hardware, let me know in the comments below what you think, what you've experienced, and where you think the future should be with this hardware. Go ahead and follow us on all of our accounts, click and subscribe, and get in our AIMarketingTools.com newsletter for the weekly updates on AI marketing tools that work. You have a good one.